Today, I'm going to show you a cool Spring Boot app that talks to three AI services, DeepSeek, OpenAI, and Gemini. Connecting to Gemini was the trickiest part. So I'll explain that step by step. Let's jump in. How to build a Spring Boot app with DeepSeek, OpenAI, and Gemini. Overview of the application. I built a simple Spring Boot app with three REST controllers. You can find the source code for it on my GitHub repository. The link is in the description below. Each controller sends a message to an AI service and returns a response. The controllers are OpenAI controller for OpenAI, DeepSeek controller for DeepSeek, following the same pattern as the OpenAI's one, Gemini controller for Google Gemini. The app starts with the chat app Spring application file. This file is very basic. It just runs the Spring Boot application. Setting up Spring Boot. I started with one of the latest versions of Spring Boot and decided to roll with Gradle. Maven is fine, but Gradle is quick to set up and easier to read. And honestly, I fell in love with it since I used it the first time in 2015. So those are the dependencies I needed. Spring Boot Starter Web, Spring AI OpenAI Spring Boot Starter, Spring AI Vertex AI Gemini Spring Boot Starter, and you can add more dependencies for the test. Deep dive into the controllers. The OpenAI controller takes a message from the URL, wraps it in a prompt, sends it to OpenAI, and returns the AI's response. The key part is the chat method, which calls chatmodel.callprompts and then extracts the content from the result. You can see how clean and simple it is. The controller shows how to connect to OpenAI's API with minimal fuss. The Gemini controller works almost exactly like the OpenAI controller. It takes the message, wraps it in a prompt, and sends it to Gemini. The key part is chatmodel.callprompt, which calls the Gemini chat model and returns the content. Gemini was the most complex integration. It required a bit more setup in the configuration file. More on that next. Configuration details in application properties. For OpenAI and DeepSeek, the setup is easy and similar. Go to OpenAI and DeepSeek's websites, sign up or login, navigate to the API settings, generate and copy your API key. Then replace my API key in the application properties with your real key. Set your chosen model as a value for the key spring.ai.openai.chat.options.model. For Gemini, things are different. Vertex AI uses Google Cloud Service accounts instead of API keys. Here are the properties I set up for Gemini. spring.ai.vertex.ai.gemini.projectid. This is your Google Cloud project ID. You need to have a project set up on Google Cloud. spring.ai.vertex.ai.gemini.credentials.uri. This property points to the file that contains your Google Cloud API key. Make sure you download your service account JSON file from Google Cloud. Go to Google Cloud Console, navigate to IAM and Admin, then Service Accounts, create a service account with the Vertex AI user role, then generate and download a JSON key file. Next we have spring.ai.vertex.ai.gemini.location. This is the region where your Gemini service is available. Change it if your project is in a different region. Then spring.ai.vertex.ai.gemini.chat.options.model. This sets the model version you want to use. Follow the steps in Google Cloud carefully and check the documentation if you get stuck. So first you need to visit the Google Cloud console, create or select an existing project, enable the appropriate APIs, in this case, enable the Vertex AI API, then go to the credentials section. In Google Cloud console, navigate to IAM and admin, then service accounts, then create a service account with the Vertex AI user role. Then generate and download the JSON key file. Now you have created a new service account and downloaded the JSON key file. Place the JSON file on your local machine and update credentials URI in your application properties with the file path. Set your project ID and location as needed. All right, let's run the application now. Open your terminal and run the command gradle bootrun, or just run the appropriate gradles task from the side menu if you are using IntelliJ IDEA just like me. For Maven, it's also similar. This will build and run the Spring Boot application. Now to test the endpoints, open your browser or use a tool like Postman. For OpenAI, go to localhost:8080/api/openai/chat?message, which is the query param. Then you can give hello, for example. For DeepSeek, go to localhost:8080/api/deepseek/chat?message, then your message. For Gemini, go to localhost:8080/api/gemini/chat?message, then your message. Enter your message as query param and see the responses. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed this quick tour. I showed you how each controller works, how to configure the application, and the steps to get your API keys. I especially highlighted the steps for connecting to Gemini via Google Cloud Console. This configuration can be tricky, but once you set it up, it's super powerful. If you found this video helpful, hit like, subscribe, and share it with your friends. I love hearing your questions and ideas, so drop a comment below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. If you are excited about diving deeper into the world of modern software engineering, from architecture to cloud and security, check out my video courses where I explore these concepts further and tackle real-world challenges. The link to the courses is in the video description below. See you next time!